to President Cram, IIT faculty, distinguished alumni, and to you, the class of 2021 of Illinois Institute of Technology. I'm honored to be speaking to all of you at your commencement from one of the most amazing technical universities in the world. Thank you, President Cram, for steering the university through the last decade, and especially through COVID-19, perhaps the worst crisis in living memory. The university is so much stronger with a keen sense of purpose and the resources to execute on its ambition because of your guidance and leadership. If this year has taught us anything, it is that life doesn't necessarily go as per plan. Life is full of surprises, some sweet and some not so sweet. For example, nobody predicted in 2020 and 2021 were going to be years of a global pandemic, one that would ravage through continents, causing so much disruption and distress. Not one of us in 2019 could have predicted that we'd be forced to lock down inside our homes and businesses, restaurants, bars, and shopping malls would be shut for nearly an entire year. We also often learn the most from these surprises. I believe all of us are incredibly lucky to have lived through this world crisis so early in our lives. It has taught us three important lessons that we may not have learned otherwise. First, it has taught us the importance of flexibility. Even the best laid plans were disrupted by the pandemic. No matter how successful or how old one was, he or she had to change. We had to be flexible. All of us learned how to work, study, even celebrate remotely, unthinkable in the pre-pandemic world. Flexibility lets us remain humble. It ensures that we remain curious and that we keep on learning. Second, it has taught us the lesson of empathy. We saw how people can be in distress for no fault of their own. Last year made us aware that there are things that are more important than any person's individual success: the well-being of our family, friends, and loved ones, the strength and comfort of our communities, the importance of celebrating small moments. We also became more aware of the shared struggles that we face in this generation: balancing the need for economic growth with sustainability, reversing the damage from climate change, and reducing the inequity in access to basics like healthcare. Third, and most importantly, it has renewed our optimism in technology and human ingenuity. Nobody really thought that vaccines, which historically took years, sometimes decades to develop, would be ready in merely months. The use of mRNA technology, the fusion of information sciences and genome sequencing, and unprecedented global collaboration accelerated this breakthrough development and is helping us get back on the path to normal lives so quickly. And this optimism that no matter how grave the challenge, we can find a way out of it through courage and innovation is your superpower. As you celebrate this important milestone in your lives virtually, a lot of you already know what you're doing next. Some of you have plans to study further. Some of you have jobs that you're excited to start after the summer. Some of you may have stumbled upon that new idea and may be boldly embarking on your entrepreneurial journeys. And a few of you may still be trying to figure out what to do next. Wherever you are on that path, one thing is certain: life will continue to throw surprises at you, that may not exactly fit your plans. When I graduated, I did not have a plan to create India's leading beer company. As I look back, a lot of what I've done in creating Beer 91 brings me back to the four invaluable years I spent at IIT Chicago as a student. I took a one-way flight from Delhi to Chicago on my 18th birthday. I still remember taking the cab from O'Hare at 6 p.m., already dark, my first time in America, and asking the cab driver to take me to McCormick Hall. I ended up at the McCormick Place Convention Center instead of our campus. Eventually, I convinced the driver that I wanted to go to McCormick Hall on 3200 South Wabash and reached campus. I got my first job at the dormitory cafeteria and learned the irreplaceable virtue of hard work. Heck, it got me paid. I came to IIT not just because of its computer science program, but because of my dad, an architect, had spent a few weeks on campus meditating around Mises' masterpieces. Secretly, I wanted to be like him, an architect. IIT taught me that it was okay to pursue your interests, even if they did not fit neatly into the recommended curriculum. Besides classes in computer science, I took classes in architecture, which helped refine my sensibility on design. I took a class in art history with Professor Jack Snapper. Professor Snapper was a big fan of jazz and frequently took the class to smoky clubs on the south side of Chicago. That was my first introduction to jazz. I became a campus rep for the Museum of Contemporary Art, primarily to get free access to the museum and its previews and parties. I even formed a book club and read books with Professor Kiros at the Rain Dog Cafe across the Art Institute of Chicago. I made some of my best friends for life on campus, from countries as diverse as Pakistan, Nigeria, Russia, Bangladesh, Japan, Korea, and France, all of whom have shaped my cultural viewpoint. I understood how all of us have a shared destiny and are inspired by similar things. The belief that no matter where one is from, deep inside, each one of us wants to succeed, do good, and perhaps play a little bit more. And I had my first beer at IIT. Still 18 and not quite drinking legal drinking age yet, I took a class on history of technology and the Industrial Revolution. Professor Thomas Misa, on the first day of class, walked in with a case of Ankur steam porters from San Francisco. He poured the beers for all the students and proudly announced, "Take a sip, boys and girls. This is what the Industrial Revolution tasted like. Porters in the dockyards of England after a hard day's work of unloading all of the spices and teas, textiles and tools from India and America got this as their evening reward." Had it not been for Illinois Tech, I wouldn't have had the confidence to be flexible, to color outside the box, to explore, to break a few rules, and to remain curious. And perhaps this computer science grad may not have ever strolled into the world of beer. As I embarked on my entrepreneurial journey, I stumbled through many obstacles, challenges that seemed insurmountable and moments that felt unwinnable. I struggled to pay the bills, meet payrolls, find customers, and raise capital. Throughout those moments, I stared at constant failure and understood sometimes people don't make it despite trying their best. I learned the importance of hard work, staying humble, and remaining true to your purpose. Win or lose, give it your best, and remember to be considerate for those who don't make it. Most importantly, however, throughout this journey, I never lost hope. Perhaps I picked up the wandering spirit of Mises' optimism that brought him to IIT for a new beginning. Somehow, I always believed that if I worked hard enough, if I stayed the course long enough and learned from every failure, I will make it. Graduates, you're entering into a new world that is full of promise. Like after every major crisis, whether it was the Spanish flu of 1918 or World War II, the post-pandemic world is on the verge of rapid growth. And perhaps for the first time in history, there is a great opportunity to solve some of the world's biggest challenges, climate change, healthcare, inequality, through transformational technological innovation. And as you enter into this amazing world, IIT has prepared you well with a solid education to make the most of this unique opportunity. As you go through the next phase of your lives, and in case you do get a surprise, in case life strays away from your plans, in case you do stumble, just remember these three things. One, remain flexible and ever curious to learn new things. Travel, see the world, work internationally at least once. Two, be empathetic. Remind yourself to do work for the betterment of the world around you, your community, and our shared humanity. Have faith in your neighbor, especially in the toughest times. Three, never lose hope. Optimism is your superpower. Optimism in a better future and the belief in yourself to make it happen. Congratulations, class of 2021. Good luck out there.